where curiosity and creativity reign, where 300-page textbooks are a thing of the past, and where we see students working on real-world projects and striving for growth rather than grades. Now, ladies and gentlemen, before we dive into just how that would work, I want to take you all back to your school days for a second. How did you consume knowledge? Was it through a textbook? Perhaps PowerPoint? Or maybe even on a chalkboard, if we're going right back? My point is, these methods have not changed in far too long, and it's time we update these to stay up to date with the latest technologies we're seeing in the field. What I want you to do is dig a little deeper and find those experiences that really stood out in your learning experiences. Was it the time you got to dissect a frog in biology? Or maybe when you got to hear from an expert in the field? Ladies and gentlemen, these are unique experiences that stand out because they appeal to our senses of sight, touch, and sound. And that's what really nurtures and grows our learning. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I don't want to dwell on the past for too long. Trust me, I've only just graduated year 12 and I'm in no rush to go back. What I want to do instead is take you to the school of the future. A school where students and teachers are working with the latest technologies to develop real-world solutions to real-world problems. A school where students are taught skills directly applicable to the industry and where they're challenged to experiment and innovate to achieve greatness. Now, this may sound like a bit of a mythical school full of unicorns and rainbows where students are actually prepared for the real world, but trust me, it's not as impossible as it may seem. I was always a little bit different. I started my first business at age 14, and by 15, I was running a technology startup. Because of this, I was immersed in the real world from a very young age, and I was seeing the gaps between the skills I was being taught in the classroom and the skills required of me in the real world. What amazed me the most was the fantastic technology that I was getting to work with as part of my job, and why none of it was making its way into my classroom. I got to spend my days working with new VR headsets. I got to see students creating with robotics, and I got to see how augmented reality can be applied to hospitals. To me, it seemed simple, easy, fun, and creative. Yet it baffled me why none of this technology was making its way into schools here in Australia. What I did find instead, though, was that these technologies were being used around the world. Now, I have a pretty awesome job. I get to work with holograms on a daily basis. And my company creates these holograms from the size of a phone and tablet up to our life-size two-meter tall units. Now, as someone that doesn't have a deep technical knowledge, I was able to do this all just on a YouTube tutorial. As a kid, I always wanted to work in the technology space, but there was always one issue. I didn't enjoy coding. Now, for anyone that knows much about the national curriculum at the moment, that's a bit of an issue. There's a lot of emphasis on coding, and for those that don't enjoy it, you just think technology is not for you. What amazed me, though, was that I could learn how to make holograms. It first amazed me that this technology existed in the real world, and what amazed me more was that I could learn how to do it all with no technical knowledge or background, all just from a 5-minute YouTube tutorial and a bit of passion and determination. I was fascinated to learn this, and it showed that if I wanted to be truly exceptional, I had to take my learning from the classroom and into the real world. And I've since made it my mission to find the latest creative technologies and teach them to students across the country. Now, when I was experimenting with these technologies, I found a whole range of schools across the world doing some really exciting things. I saw students in Hong Kong building miniature computers to measure the air quality in their geography classes. I saw students in Denmark creating works of art with their robots. And in the UK, I saw students learning about the solar system through augmented reality. It was immersive experiences that got the students to buy in, got them excited to come to class, and had fantastic results on their grades. So it made sense for us to be using them here in Australia. Now, I tried shaking my fist at the education system for a while, but realised that was going to get me nowhere. So I decided to do something about it. I started talking to educators all across the country and found that they were hungry for these new innovative programs, and they were looking for young people to take charge and to deliver them for them. Now, before long, we found schools here in Australia using holograms to teach history in their classrooms. We saw schools that were using robotics in their dance classes, and schools that were developing steam hubs for their students. Now, for those of you wondering what a steam hub is and picturing a commercial sauna, think again. These are dynamic, vibrant spaces dedicated to the studies of science, technology, engineering, arts, and mathematics. bringing the creativity into science and tech to make it fun and engaging for all students. Now, we found these schools were having wonderful results, and they weren't the schools you think would be leading the way in this. You may think these schools would have been the biggest schools in the largest cities with the biggest budgets, but really, they were the smaller schools in our regional hubs that are getting creative and innovative with the resources that they have on hand, and their students are loving it. And as well as this, we're seeing companies making their technology more and more affordable. We're seeing DIY smart home devices for as low as $25. We're seeing free augmented reality toolkits and holograms for just $30. These are things that are easy to incorporate into the budget that have fantastic return on student engagement. Now, I was recently in one of these schools and talking to one of the students. And when I asked her what she liked most about these programs, she said that she loved seeing kids solving adult problems. She understood that it's up to our generation to solve the issues facing the world today. And she thinks the sooner we can get started, the better. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you may be wondering if there's any actual evidence to support this. Whilst the use of this technology in the classroom is still very new, we're already seeing reports coming out showing that augmented reality and virtual reality has got wonderful effects in the class. We're seeing that it enhances student collaboration and positivity. We're seeing students rushing to the classroom to be able to work with these technologies. And with the combined augmented and virtual reality market expected to exceed $215 billion by 2022, with over 1 billion users around the world, it's essential that we introduce it to our students from a very young age. Now, we need to prepare our students to be lifelong learners as we prepare them for an ever-changing world. It's essential that we encourage them to experiment, explore, and innovate with their learning techniques and their projects, and get them to buy into the real-world learning. We're seeing schools explaining to students the links between the topics they're learning and the real world, and it shows the students they're not just studying for a test. It shows them that what they're doing matters and will help them going forward. Fantastic results. Now let's have a look at what students are doing in schools across the country. In Rockhampton, we have students developing marketing techniques for their local farmers using a range of immersive technologies such as augmented reality and geolocation for their animals. Up in Harvey Bay, we're seeing students tackling major societal issues such as pollution in the waterways and youth unemployment. On the Sunshine Coast, we're seeing students tackling anxiety and depression through natural methods with no medication needed whatsoever. Over in Perth, we're seeing students supporting the aging population and connecting them with young people. And here in Brisbane, we're seeing students empowering other young people to do amazing things through the use of workshops, programs, and conferences. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to think about that classroom again. The classroom where curiosity and creativity reign. Where students are immersed in real-world learning and working with industry to solve some of the issues facing the world today. And a school where students and teachers are collaborating using the latest technologies that we have available to us. So by the time they do go into industry, they're experimenting, they're innovating, testing and iterating new solutions. It's time we stop focusing on making our students digitally literate and empowering them to become digitally confident. Our generation has to solve the wave of issues set to arise in the next 20 to 30 years, and it's up to us to give them the head start and really innovate to make some fantastic solutions. So ladies and gentlemen, whether you're a parent, a student, or a teacher, let's all band together to help our students become digitally confident innovators. Thank you.